And you can see the Hi, this is parcel 2353 Benton Place on Forbes Lake in Forbes Park, Colorado. It's September 5, 2012. Just looking at the frontage along Benton Place. Comes back here to the car. Down, straight down that way to the lake. And there's a little driveway right down here that we'll walk over to. Previous owner put in about 6 years ago. And the southwest lot line is right down there along the road. We'll walk down there and look back this way a minute. Looking down the road frontage of 2353 Benton Place, see a beautiful mix of aspen, spruce, some ponderosa, a couple fir trees. And the northwest lot line along Benton Place corner is just past my vehicle down on the right there, about 15 feet past the vehicle. So this is the road frontage, very pretty. The parcel has a kind of a moderate to gentle slope, and you know, it's very buildable with or without a basement. You could put just crawl space. But also, you could put a walkout basement in a, so you could utilize a lower level finished. And right here on this, be the southwest corner along Benton Place, you can see the power transformer underground. And that's right by the corner. From right here, the lot line, I put some ribbons on the lot line. But you can see it's only about maybe 50 or 60 feet down to the common land meadows. So it kind of goes up from this power box in that general direction right down there. And then about 100 or 150 feet, probably 150 feet into the meadow toward the lake. As you can see, the lake is right down there. So from this parcel you look, it almost touches the water, and there's common lands in between, so you own that with the other owners. And you look right at the lake. Very pretty. We'll walk down the road and then down the little existing driveway that the previous owner put in. I'm back, you know, looking at 2353 from that southwest corner down there. And a little bit past the middle of the parcel, previous owner put a little gravel driveway going down under the parcel, so we'll walk down there and look around from in the middle of the parcel. Looking back up the driveway on 2353 towards Benton Place. Short little gravel driveway. Parcel has some, you know, beautiful spruce and aspens. You know, it's just beautiful right in here. Pretty little spruce trees, kind of a mix between large and small trees through here. Over here, you can see, you know, the parcel looks directly out over Forbes Lake and distant mountains, Iron Mountain. So we'll walk down to the edge of the forest where this parcel turns from forested to grass and wildflower meadow. Just go out quite a ways into the meadow, just about to down to the lake. It's about a perfect day in here, about 72 degrees, sunny, cool, about a 15 mile an hour breeze. Looking southeast from the edge of where 2353 turns from forested to grass and wildflower meadow. Most of the flowers are gone now. It's September. But you can get an idea of, you know, the scope of the views. that tree line right up there is the San Isabel National Forest. It runs for many miles that way. The lake is down about, 3 or 4 feet over its normal. Another good year of snow, and it should be full again. So this would be your views, from, a nice building site on the edge of where the parcel turns from forested to meadow. You can see it's kind of a gentle slope. Beautiful trees. Some wildflowers left here yet, but most of them are done for the season already. Almost always ducks in the lake, for viewing. Been told just the other day that a fly fishing friend of mine was fishing toward the, the opposite, to the left end of the lake over there, to the west end. And saw about 18-inch brook trout, but I have not personally fished the lake, so I really don't know. But just beautiful, about 40-acre lake for canoeing, kayaking, watching the wildlife. Lots of deer and elk in here. In the especially later September, early October during. Mating season, there'll be herds of hundreds of them. We just walked down from that little gravel driveway down a natural game trail. So they cut right through the parcel down to the lake to drink and eat grass. Also on the next two parcels going that way, 2354 and 2355. We'll walk down into the meadow. And then turn around and come back and look at, what the parcel looks like. Looking back southwest into the parcel. What looks like a little two-track right through here is actually the remnants of early 1900s narrow-gauge railroad that ran through here where they timbered this area to help build Colorado Springs and Denver and so forth. And after they timbered it out, they removed the train tracks and healing itself. But if you look carefully, you can still see where it ran along the edge of the lakes and meadows, and you can see the little cut where it used to run. Here's the nearest home that's visible from here. It's a beautiful log home, and it's a garage. They own the entire street, so I would imagine it'd be the only home on that road. There's one more home that's a little further away that is visible. It's a nice log-sided home. Maybe about 4 or 5 years old. Both very well maintained homes. Just kind of walking through the meadow here, still on the parcel. about on the back lot line? I don't see my survey stakes right at the moment. I staked this out years ago when I first sold this parcel and more recently purchased it back. Owners moved to California, so. But the parcel, the corner is somewhere right down in here. And I can easily find the stake in the pen, but I don't see it right at the moment. But the building site that we walked down on was right down there. Up there, I should say. We walked through right there. Give you some idea. Beautiful aspens and spruce. And the other lot line is up the hill in that direction, right about in there. We'll walk over that way in a minute. So it runs up and goes into the woods right up there and up to that power box that we looked at a minute ago. So it gives you some idea of what the parcel is like from this area. From here, looking at Raspberry Mountain to the south-southeast, surrounding forested mountains. From up there, you can look right out over the Front Range. So that's National Forest up in that way. From that way as well, right up there, you can look out over the Front Range, east as far as your eye can see. But right down by the water, very pretty clear water. Good for canoeing, kayaking, possibly fishing. I haven't fished it myself, just going by what people have told me. The closest physical home is about three parcels away. It's about 30 years old. A log home, maybe 2,000 square feet right up there. You can't see it from the building site at all on this parcel, but it's tucked way back up in there. And the surrounding area. This is all protected common land meadows. From right here, it's, I'd say about a mile and a half to that tree line over there, just to give you some idea of the expanse of the meadow. Common land meadow runs from up by that house, by that tree line, close to 2 miles that way. So, big area of protected commons, all grass, meadow, a lot of elk, deer, little critters, birds.